and predictability. No face masks, no high-fiving, news on TV. Everybody eventually says they missed as much as you. So everybody shouted together, hey, come watch our news real soon. Bonnie News is back, Bonnie News is back. There's a mic to hold on to. Bonnie News is back, Bonnie News is face. There's a face, somebody recording. Bonnie News is back. When you're lost out there and you're all alone, the news is waiting to brighten your day. Bonnie News is back.
Hello there, I'm Drew and I'm not the only anchor. You heard me right, since this is the last Bonnie News episode the fifth graders are doing, sadly. But throughout the episode, all the fifth grade Bonnie News crew will be the anchors. What do I do next, I questioned myself. Question. I know. Let's go to Landry and Ava S. with questions about Bonnie News.
Hello. I'm Landrick.
And I'm Ava.
Welcome to
Bonnie News Questions.
We are going to ask 2 second graders, Sophia
and Kennedy,
who was the anchors of last week's episode?
Landrick and Paxton.
Correct. What was the last segment we did in the flip-flop episode?
No!
Lunches.
Correct.
What was the first segment in the flip-flop episode?
We'll come back to that.
Yeah. Who does disasters?
Paxton does pranks.
Definitely. Oh yeah.
His name starts with D.
Disasters Duncan?
No.
No. We'll come back to that one.
Why are you coming back to it? Why don't you just tell them the answer? They both got
it. Okay.
It was Drew.
What was the first segment in the flip-flop episode?
So many hints on this one.
Random trivia?
No.
Wait.
The first one was Landrick and Paxton, which you already had. So the second one was lunches.
The third one was random teacher questions.
And then the fourth one was
Drew. It was a tie, 1-1.
Congratulations
to both of you.
One loss.
Bye!
I knew those questions because I'm in Bunny News, and they were too easy. School is almost over, and I can't wait for summer. We have done lots of segments in Bunny News. Which one is your favorite? I like all of them. The last Duncan Science Corner is coming. Let's go back to the past with Duncan. Go.
Hello, and welcome back to Duncan Science Corner. I went to lose the T-Rex and found this guy. So we're finding materials to fix my time machine. Anyway, today, we're going to talk about Triceratopses. Triceratopses lived in the late Cretaceous period, 66 million years ago. Triceratops was 30 feet long and weighed 13 tons. Triceratops ate plants and was food for T-Rex. They defended themselves with their 3 horns that would cut attackers. I think I just saw some minerals over there. Hope it will help me make my way back to the present. Well, that's all for now. Bye!
I didn't know that about Triceratops. That was fascinating. I hope Duncan got his time machine working. How good are you at jump roping? Well, the 4th and 6th graders are very good. They're so good they created routines jump roping to music. Here are the best of
I'm back to me. long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe? But I've been for Cotton Eye Joe. I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cotton Eye Joe?
Fourth and sixth grade. Those routines were out of this world. Anyways, let's talk about this is our last Bunny News episode for fifth grade, which is crazy to think that. I'll miss you guys. I'll definitely miss the Bunny News crew because it's been a lot of fun being in Bunny News. Anyways, enough about me. We should probably get running to
Welcome back to Racing for Eskos. I'm Britta and I'm here with
Kennedy.
And they're gonna be racing on the monkey bars one at a time and we're gonna time them to see who wins.
Go!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Go!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Lane 1.
Hi, were you worried about me? I just got back from the past and wow, that was it. No more facts. Anyway, that was a fast race, almost 5 seconds, which reminds me, next is Joe and Ava are doing the 5 second rule, so let's go!
Hello, welcome back to 5 second rule. I'm Drew.
And I'm Ava.
And I'm Kaysen.
Kaysen will name 3 things under 5 seconds.
Name 3 desserts.
Cake, cupcakes, and pumpkin pie.
That was okay. Really good.
Alright. Name 3 things to do when the power goes out.
Grab a flashlight, try to turn the power on and grab a blanket so you don't get scared.
Good job.
Welcome back to round 2 of 5 second rule. We're here with
Ava
from first grade. Okay, ready? Name 3 cartoon characters.
Don't know.
Okay, we'll do the next one. Ready? Name 3 Christmas songs.
Jingle bells.
She got 1. And that's it for 5 second rule.
Good job, Drew and Ava. I would do that with my twin, Braylon, again, but she does not want to play with me again because she said I did bad on the last time we did it. Oh, what is next? Ah, my favorite. Lunches. Oof. So good. Okay, let's go to lunches. Bye.
Hi, welcome to the second to last lunches. I guarantee that this week's lunches are going to be amazing. No, not amazing. Fantastic. Monday, turkey cheese sandwich, lettuce, California bun, chips, and tropical fruit. Tuesday, pork patty on a bun, corn, broccoli, bread, and mixed fruit. Wednesday, creamy hot chicken sandwich, baked beans, carrots, and oranges. Thursday, barbecue sandwich, peas, veggies, with dip, and mandarin oranges. Friday, quesadilla, lettuce salad, green beans, and peaches.
Those lunches were very excellent. Really excellent, as Harry Potter says. Guess the segment that is next. Here are some hints. It was so funny last time. It has a box. The teacher was Mrs. Arns. Bryson hosts the event. Did you get it? It is What's in the Box.
Hello. Today I'm bringing you with What's in the Box. I'm with
Mrs. H.
Today I'm doing the stuff we're doing. Okay. Round 1.
It's not going to bite me, right?
No.
Feels. It's a baby wipe? Is it a baby Close. Wipe?
Close.
That's a wipe.
Is it a Clorox wipe?
Yeah, he got it.
Round 2.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it's mushy. Feels like frozen. Frozen fruit? Fruit? Is it fruit cup?
Yeah. Round three.
I'm gonna really hope that this isn't what I think it is. And I'm gonna hope it's a snake!
See again?
Well, maybe that will stay for next year. Well, I was just thinking, when was the last Guess That Tune? Well, it's been too long, I can't remember. So I think we will do it. So let's go see what Katie's playing on our giant piano.
Katie, that was amazing. Although I couldn't guess it. I'm kidding. I knew it was the Harry Potter theme song. It was short, but that made it more of a challenge. Well, guess who is going to get in trouble? Pranks with Pax. Let's go and see what he's going to do this time.
Welcome back to Pranks with Pax.
This is the last one for the year.
But it's gonna be a good one. You will need a lot of disgusting items. And you blend it all up and make a masterpiece. Bam, you get a smoothie and a prank. We will be pranking Devin from third grade.
Hi everybody, welcome to my kitchen. Anyways, this is my smoothie. And we are going to be making Devin a delicious smoothie. Starting off with the base of all smoothies, a banana. Then you add some, Buffalo Wild Wing wild sauce. And then, maybe some lemon juice. Put a little of that in there. And then, maybe some soy sauce, delicious. Don't do too many drops of the soy sauce. Put some V8 in there. Delicious. Put some mustard. And the best mayo, big chunk in there. And then some Parmesan cheese. And then, to top it off, a cherry. And then, put some milk in there. And then, orange juice. Then, you blend it all up. Smells great too. Amazing. Now we just gotta get a cup. And now I'm ready to prank Devin.
Hi, Devin.
Hello.
I made you a smoothie.
Nice.
How is it?
Very spicy.
Want another drink?
No, never in my life.
Mine's good.
I should do that prank on my mom. She'll probably throw up. I can't believe that was the last prank of this year, but there'll always be next year. Anyways, the 4th and 5th and 6th graders created poppy posters. Here are some pictures of the winners.